Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, I'm actually going to be passing over to Matt at Collaboration Coach. Now, I have had Matt on before, you may remember his name and also the channel because he mainly covers Microsoft products. Now, he will give a bit of an outline into some of the features, also diving into how it differs as well, experience-wise from other experiences and how your team can get started. So hopefully this gives you all you need to know to learn all about Microsoft Teams and whether it's suitable for your team. So guys, I'll include Matt's channel below, Collaboration Coach, if you want to dig deeper into Teams, other such tools like SharePoint. He is an amazing individual at creating videos that are full of knowledge and information that you need to know. So do check his channel out. Without further ado, thank you very much to Matt for coming on the channel.
In this video, I'm not going to try and teach you all the features of Microsoft Teams because there's just too many. So what I thought I'd do is focus on something in particular, and that's meetings. So when I was at Microsoft, we initially had a few problems getting people to adopt Teams. They were familiar with their old tools like Outlook and they didn't want to switch. The way we got around that was to hold all our team meetings in Microsoft Teams. So people would have an excuse to go in there and gradually they'd get used to how it looked and felt and see all the benefits of using it. I'm going to talk you through setting up a meeting, how to record it, how to take notes, and how to share all the output of the meeting with the rest of the team. So first of all, I'm going to give you a quick overview of Microsoft Teams just for those who haven't seen it before. On the left-hand side here, you see I've got my toolbar. And next to that, I have my list of teams. So you can see here I'm a member of the sales team, a launch team, and a project team. And within each of those teams, you can see I've got a list of channels. So for example, in the launch team, I have general, design, design assets web, launch event, they're all channels. So within each of those channels, you can have conversations, you can share files, you can share other apps and services as well. So you can see here I'm in the launch event channel, and on the right hand side, I've got a bunch of tabs along the top and then some information in the middle. And if I switch between these different channels, you'll see the content and the apps along the top, or the tabs along the top, they change. So I'm going to choose launch event, and I'm just going to have a look at what's going on here. So you can see there's lots of people sharing different things, like they're having conversations, sharing PowerPoint, sharing other bits and pieces. So there's lots of stuff happening there. Now, if I go from the conversations tab to the files tab, you can see there are files here that I can use, so files that are specific to that channel. And then there's other apps and services like Power BI can be shared, so you can share reporting information through a Power BI dashboard. And then we've also got Microsoft Planner information here too, so you can get a glance at your plan from inside of Teams. As well as all this cool stuff, you can have meetings within your channels as well. So I'm going to talk you through how to set that up now. I'm going to come over to the toolbar on the left and choose meetings. And from the meetings, I'm going to choose schedule a meeting. Now, the first thing I need to do is name my meeting. I'm going to call it product launch meeting. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is come to my drop down here on the right hand side. And in here, I can choose the channel that I want the meeting to go into. If you remember, I was in the launch team and I wanted to have it in my launch event channel. So the good thing about that means I don't have to invite anyone else to the meeting because they're going to get notification of it because they're a member of the channel. If I want to, I can invite people. So someone outside the team that's perhaps not going to be included, you can just have a look up for the person you're interested in and it will add them as an attendee. It will show you whether they're free or busy. And if they weren't free, you could use the scheduling assistant to get a glance on when a better time might be. When you're happy with the details of the meeting, you can just hit schedule and it will add the meeting to your diary and also the conversation in the channel. So you can see how I've got my conversations tab in my launch event channel and I've got this new meeting here, product launch meeting, which has just been scheduled. You can also see if when you go to the meetings button, I've got the product launch added there too. And in that, I can see the details like who's invited and how to join. So I can join the meeting from here, or I can go back to my Teams channel and I can click on the link in the conversation, and that will also give me the meeting details. And from here, I can press join again. Now that's going to open up Teams and get me ready for the meeting. And all I want to do is press the join now button. You can see here, I can toggle on and off my video and my audio. And also we've got the blur option, so we can blur the background. So I'm not going to turn my video on for this demo. I'm just going to hit join now. It's going to take me through to the meeting. So the next thing I want to do is share my screen, because I'm going to be presenting some slides that I've prepared already. I've got PowerPoint open, I'm ready to go. So I'm just going to come to this button in the middle here, and I'm going to choose desktop. So you'd see now I've got this red bar around the edge of my screen. That means I'm presenting, so everyone in the meeting can see everything I'm presenting right now. And you can see over here, even though I'm looking at PowerPoint, I've got the meeting still running on the side here. So at any point I can close this and stop sharing and go back to the meeting. The other thing I want to do is record this meeting. So I'm going to go back to Teams, and I'm going to go to this little ellipsis here, click on that, and then choose start recording. Right. So now the recording has started, and you can see at the top here, we've got a notice, like a bar that everybody will see, saying that you're recording. You've also got the opportunity to go to a privacy policy here, which opens up a browser and shows you some details about privacy. And you can also dismiss this and just close it down. All right, so now I'm recording and I'm presenting my screen. Next thing I want to do is show my slides. So I'm going to go to PowerPoint and I'm going to present. So I can minimize this if I want to get it out of the way, so I can talk through my slides and so on. So when I'm done, I'm going to go back to Teams and I'm going to stop presenting. Now, the other cool thing you can do here is take notes. At the top right hand corner, you've got this little note icon, and you can start to take notes for the team. So say you wanted to record what was discussed, or perhaps record some actions, you could be typing that up here. You've got some formatting tools up here too, so you can do things like highlight. You can even add pictures and tables. So let's imagine our meeting's complete. We've presented our slides, we've taken our notes, and now we're ready to shut down the meeting. So all we need to do here is press the red button to hang up, and the meeting ends. Now, back in the Conversations tab, this is in the launch event, so that the channel that I created the meeting in, you can see we've had some additions to my meeting. I've got the fact that it started, a trail of what happened, the fact that there were some notes created, and also that there was a meeting recorded. And you can see here the recording has stopped and it's saving the recording to Microsoft Stream. So Microsoft Stream, if you haven't heard of that, is Office 365 video service. So it's kind of like YouTube for business. And what happens with the recording once it's finished is it's processed and uploaded to Microsoft Stream automatically for you, so you don't have to worry about it. So you may have noticed up here at the top now, there's a new tab called Meeting Notes. Now this was added automatically because we had a meeting and made some notes. So when I click on it, it should have the notes I made during that meeting. Now one of the cool things about this is that every time you have a meeting, those notes will be added to this notes section. So you'll have the history of all the meeting notes you ever made, so you can go back through them anytime you want. So in terms of things like creating actions, keeping notes, remembering what was discussed and decided, it's perfect. Now remember, because everyone in the team can see this channel, everyone has access to the notes, so there's no need to share them. Now, when I go back to the Conversations tab, what's happened now is that the recording of the meeting I made has been processed and it's been uploaded to Stream. So when I click on this new icon now, you can see it's recording meeting recorded by Matt. And if I click on, it's going to open it inline in Teams and start playing the video back for me. So that meeting starts up and you can see here's me sharing my desktop. If I switch through, you can see me present my slides. Now, because it's Stream, you can use the Stream features, like you can like the video, you can add it to a playlist, and you can watch it in full screen. So all that happened just by me pressing the record button during a meeting. And again, because it's in the channel, anyone can come here who's a member of the team and watch the video. Now, if I wanted to share the video, I can share it with the share button and get a link, which I can copy. I can copy it into a chat or an email or however I like. So it's another really easy way of sharing the output of the video. Okay, so that's a very simple demonstration of how easy it is to set up a team meeting in Microsoft Teams, record the meeting, take some meeting notes, and share the output.